everybody's just really got to have a little look hard out there. We had an almost sighting, but unfortunately we haven't been able to come across any yet. So the reason that we're out here, probably the most important thing, is that the latest data is telling us that there's about 55 Maui's dolphins left. And this number could be even, there could be even fewer Maui's than 55. We just don't know. And unfortunately, Maui's dolphins are being killed by gill netters in New Zealand waters and trawl vessels in New Zealand waters. And so what we're trying to do is we're trying to find these dolphins so that we can raise awareness of this issue before the Minister for Primary Industries, that's fisheries, makes a decision on whether or not to extend the set net, the gill net ban, which we're in right now, further around Taranaki. Fingers crossed. You know, China faced such a huge, a huge backlash from the world when they let the first dolphin in the world that we know of go extinct, and that was the Yangtze River dolphin. And we are, we can't judge them harshly because we are right at that doorstep. Unless we take action now, we will be the second country in the world, the entire world, to let a dolphin species go extinct. And the Maui's dolphin is just incredibly rare. It's just fantastic. It's so little. It's about sort of yay big, and you can fit it in a bathtub. And they
if
look.
You wouldn't, as forest bird, you would never.
And something that we're really proud that we're doing out here today is that we, as one of New Zealand's NGOs, have combined our forces with Greenpeace and WWF, so here's Rosa from WWF, and Pete Bethune, to really highlight this issue and put some pressure on this government.
Do we end up finding any Maui's dolphins? Any out there?
Well, actually,
unfortunately,
yeah.
Not. Not today. The Maui's weren't coming out to play today, but it's not surprising really, I guess, given that there's only 55 left in the entire world, and they're found all the way from the South Taranaki coast right up to near Dargaville in the north. So it's a bit like looking for a needle in a haystack, unfortunately. But we do still hold on to some hope, and that's because we know that given, even though it's a small population, we do know that there is quite good genetic diversity that remains within the population, and there's also a good number of breeding females as well, which is really important, obviously, if the species is to survive. So we're not going to give up hope. We're never going to give up hope. New Zealand got down to having one Chatham Island black robin, one female left in the world, and there's now over 250. So we've got a track record of being able to save our most endangered species, but we just need the government to take action today, not tomorrow, but today, and get the gill nets out of their water.
Yeah, absolutely. The Hector's dolphin is quite commonly known down in the South Island, and that's because it is the subspecies to the Maui's dolphin, and there's around 7,000 or so of them. So in comparison to just 55 Maui's, clearly Maui's are nationally critical right now. Whereas Hector's dolphin, the kind of cousin of the Maui's dolphin, if you like, they've got a few more, but they're still endangered. So we need to protect all of New Zealand where these dolphins are found, because the survival of Maui's dolphins really does depend on the survival of the Hector's dolphin, because we need to maintain that genetic diversity in case there is some breeding. We haven't seen it yet, but there's hope, because the recent surveys found two female Hector's dolphins swimming up here off the west coast of the North Island where the Maui's are found. So genetically Maui's look good. There is a slightly bias towards more females in the current population, and thirdly, there's two female Hector's dolphins. So perhaps, you know, they could interbreed and help the species recover. So we need to protect all habitats across the North and South Island where these dolphins are found.
So there's hope, basically.
There's definitely hope.
There's always hope. We're not going to give up on these dolphins.